Now let us consider heat capacity. What is meant by heat capacity? It is the amount of heat required to rise the temperature of the given substance through 1 degree centigrade or 1 Kelvin. Take the given substance, suppose this is the substance. I want to rise the temperature of this substance through 1 degree centigrade or 1 Kelvin, because either centigrade scale or Kelvin scale, the difference in temperature is same. Let us say Q is the heat required to rise the temperature of this substance through 1 degree centigrade or 1 Kelvin. Say Q is the temperature required. That is what we call heat capacity. Now, instead of 1 degree centigrade or 1 Kelvin, let us imagine the temperature rises T degree centigrade. When I supply Q amount of heat, temperature changes by T degree centigrade. For 1 degree centigrade change, what is the heat required? This is Q by T. This is called heat capacity or thermal capacity. So both are saying thermal capacity or heat capacity is the amount of heat required to rise the temperature of the given substance through 1 degree centigrade. For T degree centigrade, if I imagine Q, then for 1 degree centigrade it is Q by T. So this is called, denoted with H. Now what is the unit? Q, let us say CGS, Q is calorie, temperature, degree centigrade. Or if I consider SI system, joule per Kelvin. So calorie per degree centigrade or joule per Kelvin is the unit of thermal capacity or heat capacity. What is the relation between these two? One calorie per degree centigrade. We know that one calorie means 4.2 joule. So it is 4.2 joule per Kelvin, because difference is the same. So degree centigrade or Kelvin, if whatever I use, the value remains same. So it is 1 calorie per degree centigrade in CGS equal to 4.2 joule per Kelvin. So amount of heat required to rise the temperature of the given substance through 1 degree centigrade is called heat capacity. Now suppose if I consider the mass also, that is called specific heat. For example, for M mass, let us say heat capacity is H. For unit mass, what is the heat capacity? So it is H by M. So this is called specific heat or specific heat capacity. It is the heat capacity of unit mass. Or already I know H is equal to, just now we observed H is Q by T. So I can write as Q divided by M into T. Or amount of heat required, Q, to rise the temperature of unit mass through 1 unit temperature change. The heat required to rise the temperature of unit mass through unit 1 degree centigrade or 1 Kelvin is defined as specific heat or specific heat capacity, denoted by the symbol S. So S is equal to Q by MT implies Q is equal to MST. So Q is the heat required to rise the temperature of M mass through T degree centigrade, and S is called its specific heat or specific heat capacity. So what is the unit of specific heat? So from this equation, Q means calorie, CGS system let us take, by mass, gram, this is degree centigrade, or joule by kg, Kelvin. So the relation between these two, 1 calorie per gram per degree centigrade is equal to 4200 joule per kg per Kelvin. This is because calorie means 4.2, but gram is 10 to the power of minus 3, goes to the numerator, it becomes 4200. So the relation between CGS and SI units. Now the specific heat of water in CGS value, it is easy to remember, 1 calorie per gram per degree centigrade. Specific heat of ice, 1 by 2 or 0.5 calorie per gram per degree centigrade. The similarly, specific heat of earth, easy to remember, it is 1 by 4 or 0.25 calorie per gram per degree centigrade. Specific heat depends on the nature of the material. Once you change the material, automatically value changes. It is independent of mass. heat capacity depends on mass, because if you compare the previous equation, this h here, h is equal to from this m into s. So this h depends on mass, specific heat depends on nature of the material. Specific heat is independent of the mass, but heat capacity depends on the mass. As the mass changes, automatically heat capacity value changes. Now if I take that h is equal to ms, here we can define a quantity called water equivalent. So what is this water equivalent? It is the number of grams of water which has the same heat capacity as that of the given substance. For the given substance, calculate the heat capacity. Now take equal water. How many grams of water is required to have the same heat capacity? For example, H of the substance, let us say H of water. So H of water means M into S water. Already I know S water is 1, therefore this is equal to M. So the heat capacity of the substance is equal to number of grams of water. Why I am using number of grams? CGS system only SW is 1. Therefore number of grams of water which has same heat capacity as that of the given substance is water equivalent. Suppose if I say a substance has water equivalent, let us take an example, water equivalent is 100 grams. A substance has water equivalent 100 grams, that means its heat capacity H is equal to 100 calorie per degree centigrade, because M into S, calorie per degree per gram per degree centigrade, calorie per degree centigrade, because we are interested only H. So if 100 gram is the water equivalent, then heat capacity is 100 calorie per degree centigrade. So like that, the magnitude of heat, H and water equivalent in CGS system are equal. This is 100, this is also 100. So water equivalent is the number of grams of water which has the same heat capacity as that of the given substance. The number of grams of water which has the same heat capacity as that of the substance. Here the substance state is not changing, just I am trying to rise the temperature. Now suppose if I want to change this temperature, because we know that matter exists in three states. Matter exists in three states: solid, liquid and gas. If you take a solid, heat it, as the temperature is increased, at one temperature it is converted into liquid. If you rise the temperature of the liquid, at one temperature it is converted into gas. Best example, ice, water, vapor. These are the three states of the same material. Ice is a solid state. Ice is solid state, water is a liquid state, and vapor is a gas state. When you take ice, supply heat, it is converted into water. Still supply heat, it is converted into vapor. This is possible at 0 degrees centigrade, whereas this is possible at 100 degrees centigrade. So when the substance is changing from one state to the other, so let us consider the state change. Amount of heat required to change the state of the substance for unit mass, the heat required is what we call latent heat. For example, for M mass, heat required is Q to change the state. Here our assumption, temperature constant, temperature of the material substance is constant, but state change is taking place. For M mass, Q is the heat required. For unit mass, how much heat is required? This is Q by M, denoted by L, called as latent heat. It is the amount of heat required to change the state of unit mass of substance at constant temperature. For unit mass, how much it is required? For M mass, it is L, Q. For unit mass, this is Q by M, or Q is equal to ML. This is useful when the state change is taking place. State change. temperature constant but state change is taking place. For example, latent heat of ice, this is possible at 0 degree centigrade. It is 80 calorie per gram, because the unit for latent heat here it is L calorie per gram, or SI system if I take joule per kg. So if I take the conversion, 1 calorie per gram is equal to 4200 joule per kg. So in Cs system, latent heat of ice 80 calorie per gram, and latent heat of vapor, this is possible at 100 degree centigrade. At 100 degree centigrade, water is converted into vapor. It is 540 calorie per gram. That means if I take 1 gram of vapor water to convert it into steam, 540 calories required. Suppose if I take 1 gram of vapor to convert into water, 540 calorie of heat is to be removed. So latent heat is not only for addition, it is the amount of heat given in or taken out, both are possible. Amount of heat given in or taken out by unit mass of substance when changing from one state to the other. Ice, water, vapor. Suppose if I want to convert ice into water, supply heat. If you want to convert water into vapor, ice, take out, because heat must be removed. Same thing here also, water to vapor, we have to supply heat, whereas vapor to water, remove heat or take out heat. So whenever the state change is taking place, we are going to use this relation L. Only temperature change, no state change, then Q is equal to MST. State change, Q is equal to ML. So temperature change it is Q is equal to MST, state change it is Q is equal to ML.